Come down as usual, so that by the time you finish swimming out, the church will already. One is to come down as usual, so that by the time you finish swimming out, the church.
You guys okay?
Yeah, you okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Okay.
Nothing out. The Lord gave and the Lord is taken away. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
If we live, we live to the Lord. And if we die, we die to the Lord. So that whether we live or whether we die, We are the Lord's. For to this end, Christ died and lived again, that he might be known both of the dead and of the living.
Our Savior Christ Jesus abolished death and brought life and mortality to the gospel. I am the first and the last. I am in dreams and must die. And behold, I am alive forevermore, and I am the keys of death and of hell.
Because I live, you will live also, and death shall be no more. Neither shall there be mourning, nor crying, nor pain, for the first things are passed away. We continue the service of celebration as we sing the hymn, "To God be the glory, great things he hath done."
Thank you.
pray. Most gracious God, we turn to you at this time. In the sorrow and grief of our bereavement, praying that we may find the strength we need in your sustaining grace. So that Lord, even as we mourn the death of Anthony, whom we knew and loved, we may not be overcome by this trial, but we may hold fast, trusting in your goodness and your mercy. Assure us, O Lord, our God, that death is not the end of those who trust in you. And may our hearts be so composed in the Holy Spirit that all fear and bitterness may be swallowed up in the light and peace you give to your troubled children. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Almighty and eternal God, who by the Holy Spirit minister to us in our weakness, and by the victory of your Son, Jesus Christ, have given us the pledge of eternal life, lift us at this time, we pray, above all present distress and sorrow, and shed the light of your grace and glory upon us, through the same Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. The declaration of purpose. My brothers and sisters in Christ, we are met in this solemn moment to commend Anthony Oliver Decor. Into the hands of Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, who sent His Son Jesus Christ to be our Redeemer, by whose stripes we are healed, and in whose name alone we have salvation. So let us at this time recall to mind the life of our deceased brother, and then in humble trust here, the words of Holy Scripture. And so at this time we're going to have some tributes, and if you have your order of service, I would like us to follow the order in which the tributes come on the order. So is Antonia the call here?
Yes.
So we begin with you and we follow the order.
Go ahead.
Okay.
Good morning. Is it working? Good morning. Good morning. I'll be reading a poem called Lost. When I lost you, I lost myself too. I feel lost and alone and I don't know what to do. It's a never-ending nightmare of pain that feels like nails are being driven into my heart and then pulled out again. Night and day, the prevailing thought in my head is that you're dead. I know I will never get over it, but somehow I have to get through it. I take small steps through the darkness, guided by my grieving heart. Time and distance have disappeared as I've been torn apart. The grief road is so long as it stretches lifelong, so it's hard to carry on and to be strong. I know I'll be lost until I find you, so I look for you everywhere. I know you're there and I just can't see you. Sometimes I stop and stare because I think I've seen you, but it's just someone who looks like you. I look at your photos, willing your eyes to give me a clue. It's so hard to accept that I've lost you. I would walk through endless miles through wind and rain and back again. I will climb mountains, walk through deserts, and sail on stormy seas. I would walk until I fell into my knees. For every mile, I would shed a tear. And for every year, I would endure the pain. If only I could find you again. On behalf of my mother, Rita Maxime, she sends her tributes. She says, thank you for being there, for when I was ill, staying on the phone with me until morning, when I could not fall asleep. I miss her calls every night. You was my only company. Rest in peace, Anthony.
Greetings, everyone. This is a tribute from Frankie. My big brother, Anthony, Tony, Redman, gone too soon. I unfortunately was unable to make it to see you one last time and to bid you farewell. I will miss our Sunday's WhatsApp video calls. The memories we share will help me though. Rest in peace, my brother, until we meet again. Forever in my heart, Frankie.
On the border there is space for two or three persons from the church. If you wish to pay tribute, you come now, please. In that case, anybody from the congregation who wish to pay tribute, you can come now. No? Right. Then we move to the song from Hannah Williams.
Thank you. you.
And I'm shut out.
And won't save the lives. Look for me in the rainbows, rolling up in the sky. In the morning sunrise, when all the world is new, just look for me and love me as you know I loved you. Time for me to leave you, I won't say goodbye. Look for me in the rainbows, high up in the sky. In the evening sunset, when all the world is new, just look for me and love me, and I'll be close to you. It won't be forever, the day will come. And then my loving arms will hold you. When we meet again, time for us to part now. We won't say goodbye. Look for me in the rainbows, shining in the sky. Every waking moment and your whole life through, just look for me and love me as you know I loved you. Just wish me to be near you and I'll be there with you. Rest in peace, Grandpa. Time for me to go.
Time for me to go, meaning he's finished? Good. Thank you very much. At this time we invite Jody the Caul to remind us of Anthony's life, the eulogy.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you for coming to celebrate the life of our father. My dad never knew how to swim. If he went to the beach with you, he was going in whatever he had on. Most of the time, it was a jeans and a t-shirt. Picture a wet jeans going into the beach. Every Saturday, he would drop us off in Kittles by our aunt. And the last thing he'll tell us when before leaving is, don't go down by that beach, you know. So we'd look at him and say, okay. As soon as he made that right turn, hey, what time are we going? Fast forward a couple years later, I'm 32 years old, he drops me off and he says, don't go down by that beach, you know. So I'm looking at him, I was like, should I tell him the truth? But I figured, hey, okay, just be fine. I looked at him and said, okay, he made that right turn, you know the rest of the story. My dad wasn't a perfect man, far from it. He had a split-second temper. I remember one time messing with CGN, he kept saying, behave yourself, behave yourself. So I ended up slapping and blood started running from her mouth. He hit me with the hose that he had in his hand. It felt like two electric chairs. And that's the funny thing is, that's the only thing CGN ever remembers. She always says, every time she gets, she says, remember when daddy even beat you with the hose? Funny, I've never heard him say, I love you. You know, every time he'd say, tell your sisters I love you, and take care of yourself. I knew exactly what take care of yourself meant. All through that, you couldn't ask for a better father. I remember one time I came home on vacation, and I'm walking in the dark, and a truck pulls up next to me, the driver says, Willie, you can't walk around St. Vincent like that no more. Them boys just robbed. There's a guy in the back of the truck, he says, boy, then I read my son. But nobody now touch him. Me know what deal with the man who have to deal with Redman. The Redman are easy for dealing. I'm thinking, wow. I took him to the doctor the next day. The doctor told him everything that he needs to do. He pulls the needle out and says, I need some blood. As soon as he saw the needle, he's like, oh, my mother. I'm like, wow. Look at this bad man. What kind of bad man is scared of needles? So, I remember twice I got myself into a couple of situations where I got to get home. I have nobody to call but him. But I'm so scared that he's going to ask me a bunch of questions. I called him up twice. No questions asked. He says, I'm on my way. I'm on my way. I can't remember. I can't even remember telling him thanks for coming to get me. But all through that, he remained being a great, great father to me. He was basically my mechanic, my marriage counselor, everything. Every time I call him, we'd laugh at CGN, not knowing how that car needs an oil change. We'd laugh at Haley that most of the time she didn't answer the phone when he called. He'd fuss about Chris. I was the only perfect one. Sometimes I'd call him and he'd say, everything all right? I'd say, yeah, everything's good. He'd say, you sure? You're my son, and I know when something's not right. And we just start talking. Oh, man. I remember a guy came by earlier this week to drop some stuff off to the house, and he says, my parents left. They didn't leave anything for me, but they left a blessing on me. And right there, I remember, I thought, my dad left a blessing on how to be a great father. The day before we found out that he passed, I'm in church with my family and my little son sitting in my lap. He turns to me and he says, Dad, you're my hero. That was one of the proudest moments as a father. And I thought to myself, I learned from the best. God, I know you're listening. Can you tell my daddy I love him? He's my hero. Thank you all.
Thank you, my brother. We continue as we sing the hymn as printed. When the roll is called up yonder. Friend, Reverend the Honorable Stevenson. You see the people on the news, so stand up and let them see you. Huh? My brother and friend. Is this brother?
Yes.
Really?
Yes.
So they're twin brothers? And they're left-handed alike? Okay, and then we have with us... Yes, I'm saying we have here Brother Noel Dixon, a politician. I said I was going to recognize the politicians. It's a blessing to have you among us, my brother. He belonged here, you know. For some reason, he had left. But I know he's coming back. Nothing happened before its time. And he knows he used to be sitting over here. Right, Mr. Caul? Yeah, he used to be sitting right over here. So time will tell us whether or not you'll be back here doing what you're supposed to do. Let us see. When the roll is called up yonder.
Thank you.
Two readings that will be done today. The first comes from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, reading verse 1 to 8. And the second reading comes from 1 Corinthians chapter 13. Please come.
Good morning.
Could you just adjust the mic before?
Good morning again. Our reading is taken from Ecclesiastes chapter 3, verses 1 to 8. To everything there's a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born, a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up, a time to weep, a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones, and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace, a time to refrain from embracing, a time to get and a time to lose, a time to keep and a time to cast away, a time to render and a time to sow, a time to keep silent and a time to speak, a time to love, a time to hate, and a time of war and a time of peace. May the Lord add a blessing upon the reading.
Good morning. Second reading is from 1 Corinthians 13, verses 4 to 7. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It will always protect, always trust, always hope, always perseveres. End of the scripture.
What a friend we have in Jesus. All our sins and griefs to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer.
Let's see him where we're going to sing, but just after the singing of that hymn, you'll notice on your order that
the homily would be done by Reverend Cornelius Harry. But since he has a tired voice, and since his colleague is coming back from vacation fresh and strong, he has given way so that my colleague and brother will bring the homily, Reverend Wasie Tava Bula Bula. Let us sing. What a friend we have in Jesus.
Whoa!
thank God for the life of our dear brother, Anthony Caul. He has leave everything behind and left his dear family and left us to a place where God has prepared for him. He leave his family, his people, his house, his everything. Everything that belonged to him, left behind. He can't carry anything. But only one thing remains, that is the love of God that will never leave us at any time. Are you prepared for this day when you will leave everything behind and only the love of God that will remain in you, that will take you to a place that the Lord has prepared for those who trust in him? Let us pray. Dear Lord, you are the Father of all mercies, who cares for all your people with everlasting love, O God. You are the God of all comfort, who consoles those who are suffering the death of the loved ones. You are the God of all peace, who has promised to pour out your perfect peace into the heart of your children who are going through pain and suffering that the loss of a precious loved one brings. Almighty, our Heavenly Father, our Lord, I pray that you will become their strength in this time of loss, you will become their hope in this time of bereavement, their joy in this time of sorrow, and their peace, the turmoil that their hearts must be facing. Lord, thank you, God. Thank you that the sting of death has been broken forever, and the curse of the grave has been destroyed through the death and the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. He has broken forever the power of death and hell. For all who trust in his name, O God. Lord, speak into the hearts of your children that are mourning at this time, and let them not mourn those who have no hope. The Lord, for those that do not yet know you as their Savior who died for them, O God. Lord, I pray that they will come to know and accept you as their Savior, and find their perfect rest in you, O Lord. Lord, this is our prayer as we commit this time into your care. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. Who shall separate us from this love of God? The love of Jesus. And this is the greatest lesson that Christians should learn. There is nothing nor anyone can ever separate him or her from the love of Christ. As Brother Anthony has lived us, nothing can separate him from the love of Christ. This is a story of a man who has been put into prison frequently. A man who has been flogged severely
exposed to death again and again for the cost of Christ. He has been unmercifully beaten, whipped alive many times. 3 times this man has been beaten with rods, stoned once, shipwrecked 3 times, and spent a night and a day in an open sea before getting ashore. He has been in danger of swollen rivers, bandits along roads, and in danger both in Jewish and non-Jewish, government leaders, and travel in dangerous areas in foreign countries. One day he said, this man said, I've been labored and toiled and have often gone without sleep. I have known hunger and thirst. I've often gone without food. I've been cold and naked. I know how to go through all those situations. The amazing Christians who wrote these words, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? That is Paul. Shall tribulations, shall distress, shall persecution or famine, or nakedness or peril or sword? In fact, again, he says, nothing, none of the above, or all of them together, can separate us from the love of Christ. The Apostle Paul also quotes from Psalm 44, verse 22. He says, just as it is written, for the sake we are being put to death all day long, we are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. Will anything or anyone ever make Christ cease to love us? But not in Paul's imaginations or experience. My dear brothers and sisters, the Christian walk through life secured by the strong cable of God's graces, God's gracious unchanging love, nothing or anyone will able to separate us from this love of Christ that is in Jesus our Lord. The term the love of Christ may be taken either as our love to Christ or his love to us. But in this context, it is best to take as Christ's love for us. First thing, tribulation. Tribulation. Will tribulation separate us from the love of Christ? Tribulation refers to the affliction and trials, sorrows, troubles, pressures, and hard circumstances that pressing down on us everyday life. The word ellipsis has to do with pressure. The Latin word which the word tribulations comes, ellipsis. It is a dressing sledge that was covered on the bottom of the strip of metal that was used to separate the head of grain from the husk of chaff. The pressure of life that presses down on us and forcefully threshes us like stalks of grain. But apostles says, no tribulations. No matter how severe, will separate us from the love of Christ? No. No tribulation. How hard the situation that pressed me down. My health, my finance, politics, and so many things that press us down. Even nowadays, so many things that press us down. Price just gone up. It presses us down. Life is getting hard. It presses us down. But nothing can separate us from the love of Christ that is in Jesus. Brothers and sisters of Christ, no tribulations. No tribulation can separate us from the love of Christ that is in Jesus. No matter how hard the situation that you go through in life, nothing can separate us from the love of Christ. The second one is distress. The narrowness and the distress of being confined in a tight and oppressive space. We feel like that we are being squeezed in and there is nowhere to go. Nothing can squeeze us out from the love of God. The world disasters draw us closer to Him. Whatever situation that tries to squeeze you out, but it will never separate you from the love of Christ. No matter how hard the situations and circumstances of life that you go through now, my brothers and sisters, Christ loves you. That is why John 3:16 says, "For God so loved the world, He gave His only Son, Jesus Christ. For those who ever believes in Him will never perish, but have everlasting life." As long as you live, make a decision. Draw near to Him. Because one day you will be pushed forward into a church like our dear brother Anthony. And there is no more chance for Brother Anthony. Once you still have the breath of life, you have the chance to repent. Go to a church. Draw near. Whatever situation that tries to squeeze you out, the love of God will rescue you and show you the way. The way, because Jesus said, "I am the way, the truth, and the life." The third thing is persecution. Persecution. Persecution is the word that being hunted down like a wild animal, put to flight and driven away. Driven away with hostile force. It is to pursue with hostile intent because of the love of Christ, Jesus Christ our Lord. Christians will always be persecuted to the extent that they are faithful witness to Christ in a hostile world. But persecution, no matter how severe or intense, will never separate you and me from the love of Christ. Persecutions. Are you stand bold to proclaim that I am a Christian? It is not easy to be a Christian. As our superintendent always shares, if someone come to your house and break your house and you caught the man, take your wallet, take your laptop or your phone, what will you do to him? If you are Christians, what will you do? Will you call the police, arrest this man? Or if someone come and cut your planting that is full, and you caught the man right there, what will you do? Will you tell them, okay, you can take the planting? Not easy to be a Christian. Not easy. Because you have to show that you are Christians. The fourth thing is famine. Famine. It's hunger. Doing without food because of being driven from homes, from their homes by persecutions. persecuted Christians have been driven from their homes and jobs to wander amid strangers and desolate places. Nakedness, lack of insufficient clothing because of being reduced to poverty by the enemies. The poverty is so severe to Christians, but they were unable to purchase clothing. Two very important things of men, food and clothes. But many of us love food and don't want to share. Many of us love clothes and continue to buy new clothes every week. I always share. I join the buy and selling, SVG buy and selling, people selling clothes. People selling clothes, very expensive. But people buy expensive clothes. And they will continue to buy clothes, and their clothes are piled up while the others were naked. Nothing can separate you from the love of Christ. Not even your clothes. Not even your clothes. Food! Why are people steal? Because of food. Why are people greed? Because of money. Money for what? Money for food. Everything goes for food, going for clothing, and everything. But those two very important things, it will never separate you from the love of Christ. Brothers and sisters, share what you have. Share your clothes. Share your food. Because one day you will leave. See, Brother Anthony, have you seen any suitcase? Or any bag of clothes? Or a cup of tea? No. Him alone in the casket. And one day you will join Brother Anthony. My dear family, share what you have. Receive Christ in your heart. And he will show you the way to heaven, not a way to hell. Satan is a liar. He always a liar. But you must know the way to heaven. And that is Jesus. The last point is peril. It's a danger of any kind, natural or illegal, to which Christians are exposed because they are believers. The idea is to be at risk or face a danger, a sword, used figuratively for a violent death. Christians are executed and murdered because of their faith in Christ. This century is most violent against Christians in the history of the church. The men who ask the answerable questions, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? He was murdered because of his love for Christ. For our sake, we face death all day long. We are considered as sheep to be slaughtered. Paul is empathetic in the statement that nothing in life or death can separate us from the love of Christ. To live in Christ and to die is better yet. We have Christ in life and we have Christ in death. We have him in even better relationship. Death is only an open door to a deeper and more wonderful experience with our God. The love of Christ is eternal and unchanging. It meets us right where we are taken out. Right where we are and take us out of our darkness into light. From death to life, God loves us with an intimate love in which nothing, nothing, and nothing can separate us, my brothers and sisters. I invite us this afternoon to have a relationship with God. For those of you who never or planned to invite Christ to be your Savior, please make a decision for your life. Today is the day, and now is the hour. Don't lose any moment, because you still have the breath of life. We don't know what tomorrow brings. While you still have the breath of life, make a decision. Make a decision. I'm very serious with this. Because there are so many wicked things that happens in the world. Why? Because of those wicked spirits, of those who never take Christ as their Lord and their Savior. When they died, their spirit never goes up to heaven. It's just floating around the area. And those wicked spirits, they contribute to the work of wickedness to the people who are still alive. The wicked behavior into our community. For those of you, my brothers and sisters, for those who watch us virtually, for those of you who are here, be mindful of your heart. Be mindful of your body. Nothing can separate us from the love of Christ. Take Christ seriously. Make a serious relationship with Him. Don't mingle with sins. Leave sin away. Take Christ as your Lord and your Savior, because He will show you the way to heaven. So when you die, your soul and your spirit will go right to Him and wait for the judgment days. Don't let your soul and your spirit flows around this community of Stubbs and Calder. Don't let your spirit float. Let your spirit wait in heaven for that last day, for the judgment days, where God will come and separate the sheep and the goat. The sheep will go to the right, and the goat will go to the left. You know that story. For those who help while they were still on earth, while I'm naked, will give me clothes. While I'm hungry, you give them food. See? While they were in prison, you visit them. You pray for them while they were in hospitals. You feed those who are there. You help them. But what about the goats? They think of themselves very selfish. Very selfish. People are just thinking of themselves, to clothe nicely, to live in a good house. It's not bad. To have much money in the bank, to wear good clothes and eat good food. But one day you will be end up in the same casket. And you will be asked, when are you naked? When are you hungry? People are just around your community. People are just around your town and cities. People are in prisons. Do you visit them? Those who are in hospital, do you pray for them? Those who are around us, homeless, do you give them food and clothes? It's very challenging. Very challenging. Not easy. Road to heaven, it's not easy. One day, you will be pushed into a church, and that is your last days. That's your last days. Visit a church. Don't sleep on Sunday. I'm always sure. Don't sleep on Sundays. Visit a church. Because some people don't go to church. And when they die, the relative look for a church. Don't stay at your home. Because when you die, this is the last house you will live. Visit a church. So when you die, you will not be a visitor into the church. Visit a church. Many people are just staying around in their homes when Sundays, time for relax. Time for relax and sleep. And when Monday comes, they rush to work. But when they died, they look for a church. So when you are still alive, go to a church. Visit a church. Because you will leave your home. And this church, all the churches, it will be the last house you will go to before your 6 feet under rest for the day of judgment. My brothers and sisters, I do hope that we will live after this funeral. We will take Christ seriously. Read your Bible, pray every day, Do whatever that is important. Be mindful of your heart, of your behavior. Look to your neighbor. Look around you. Make sure that everything is well with you. Christ will be happy and God will be appreciated. For him be the glory. For him be the honor. Because we do the right thing on earth. In the name of God the Father, the Son, and the Spirit. Amen. Amen. Let us stand for the Apostle Creed. Apostle Creed. Together, 2, 3. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary and suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified and was buried. On the third day he rose again, he ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father and will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, the life everlasting. Amen. And remain standing by our next hymn, It Is Well With My Soul.
Please have your seat.
Let us go to God in prayer, prayers of thanksgiving. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Praise be to you, O God our Father, who created us in your own image for eternal fellowship with you. Praise and thanksgiving to you, O Christ, our Lord and our God, who have overcome the sharpness of death and opened the kingdom of heaven to all believers, and are now seated at the right hand of God in the glory of the Father. Praise and blessing be to you, O Holy Spirit, God our Comforter, who bear witness within us of our acceptance with the Father, and have become the pledge of our eternal inheritance. All praise and glory, blessing and honor, thanksgiving and worship be to you, O blessed Trinity, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. We bless your name today for the life of our departed brother, Anthony, whom we today lay to rest. We give you thanks for the joy and the blessing Anthony's life has brought to others, for Anthony's service to his generation according to your will, and for every happy remembrance of Anthony's life. We bless you for your mercy and goodness, which have followed Anthony all the days of his life, that now the trials of this world are over and death itself is past. Lord, receive Anthony into your perfect kingdom and bring us with all who have lived and served you faithfully to the fullness of your eternal joy through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Let us stand. The commendation. Eternal God, who have hid nothing, who have made us all and hid nothing that you have made, and have given your Son Jesus Christ for our redemption, we commend our departed brother, Anthony, to your perfect mercy and wisdom. Eternal rest grant unto him, and let perpetual light shine upon him. The Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Amen.
Working in Father pities his children, so the Lord pities those who fear. For he knows our frame, remember that we are dust. As for man, his days are as grass, and clouds are thinking for his origin. For the wind passes away, and he is not. The place thereof shall be no more. For the mercy of the Lord is for